Imagine growing fresh, delicious food without soil. Now picture doing it without electricity. This is the magic of passive hydroponics. It's a simple yet powerful way to grow food anywhere, regardless of power access. This guide is for everyone. Whether you're an urban gardener with limited space, an off-grid enthusiast, or just curious about sustainable living, passive hydroponics has something for you. We'll explore the benefits, different systems, and even share inspiring success stories. Get ready to discover a world of possibilities. By the end, you'll have the knowledge to start your own passive hydroponic garden. Let's dive in. Passive hydroponics is all about simplicity and efficiency. Unlike conventional hydroponics, it doesn't rely on pumps or electricity to circulate nutrient-rich water. This makes it incredibly cost-effective to set up and run. These systems are perfect for small-scale, sustainable farming. They use less water than traditional gardening, as the water is constantly recycled. Plus, you can say goodbye to weeding and soil-borne pests. Perhaps the biggest advantage is the low maintenance. Once set up, passive hydroponic systems practically run themselves. This makes them ideal for beginners and busy individuals who still crave the satisfaction of growing their own food. Ready to explore the world of passive hydroponics? This fascinating method of growing plants without soil has been gaining popularity for its efficiency and sustainability. Let's meet the four most popular systems that you can easily set up at home or in a small-scale commercial operation. The simplest of all, the Kratky method, uses no moving parts. It's a passive system that doesn't require electricity or pumps. Plants are suspended in a non-circulating nutrient solution, with their roots partially submerged. This allows them to absorb nutrients directly from the water. This system relies on capillary action, where water moves up through the plant roots, ensuring they stay hydrated. A wick draws nutrient solution from a reservoir to the plant's roots, ensuring a constant supply of moisture. This method is simple and effective for small plants. Ideal for larger setups, this method involves floating plants on rafts in a nutrient-rich solution. It's perfect for growing leafy greens and herbs. Airstones provide oxygen to the roots, which is crucial for plant health and growth. This helps prevent root rot and promotes vigorous growth. This system uses a bed of clay pebbles to support the plants. The pebbles provide stability and allow for excellent drainage and aeration. Nutrient solution is periodically flooded and drained, providing both moisture and oxygen. This method is great for a variety of plants, including vegetables and flowers. Each system has its own advantages and is suited for different types of plants. Whether you're growing herbs, vegetables, or flowers, there's a hydroponic system for you. We'll explore the best crops for each system next. Stay tuned to find out which plants will thrive in your chosen hydroponic setup. One of the joys of passive hydroponics is the variety of crops you can grow. Here are some top performers. Leafy greens like lettuce, spinach, arugula, and kale thrive in most passive systems, especially the Kratky method. Herbs such as basil, mint, parsley, and cilantro add flavor to your dishes and grow quickly in wicking systems. For medium difficulty, tomatoes can be grown in larger passive systems like the floating raft or clay pebble bed. Strawberries, with proper support and sunlight, can flourish in a well-maintained wicking system. Remember, success also depends on your local climate and the specific setup you choose. Don't be afraid to experiment and see what works best for you. 5. Kratky Made Easy, a step-by-step setup guide. Let's get our hands dirty, well, not really since it's hydroponics, and set up a Kratky system. This method is perfect for those who want to grow plants without the mess of soil. It's simple, efficient, and highly rewarding. It's the perfect starting point for beginners. Even if you've never grown a plant before, you'll find this method straightforward and enjoyable. Materials you'll need: a wide-mouth glass jar or container, which will serve as the reservoir for your nutrient solution. The size of the container can vary depending on the number of plants you want to grow. Net cups to hold the plants. These cups will allow the roots to grow through and access the nutrient solution below. Growing medium like coconut coir or rock wool, which will support the plants in the net cups. You'll also need hydroponic nutrients to feed your plants, and a pH testing kit to ensure the water is at the right acidity level, and of course, seedlings or young plants. Choose plants that are well suited for hydroponic growth, such as lettuce, herbs, or even strawberries. Steps. 1. Prepare the nutrient solution. Fill your container with water and mix in the hydroponic nutrients according to the instructions. This solution will provide all the essential minerals and nutrients your plants need to thrive. Adjust the pH to the appropriate level for your chosen plants. Most plants prefer a pH between 5.5 and 6.5. Use your pH testing kit to check and adjust the levels as needed. 2. Plant your seedlings. Gently place your seedlings or young plants in the net cups filled with growing medium. Be careful not to damage the roots during this process. 3. submerge the net cups. Make sure the bottom of the net cups are submerged in the nutrient solution, allowing the roots to access the water and nutrients they need. Leave an air gap between the solution and the base of the plant. This gap is crucial, as it allows the roots to get oxygen, which is essential for healthy growth. 4. Place in a sunny location. Find a bright spot for your Kratky system, ideally receiving at least 6 hours of sunlight per day. This will ensure your plants get enough light for photosynthesis. Sunlight is vital for the growth and health of your plants. If natural sunlight is not available, consider using grow lights to supplement the light requirements. Precautions: avoid using tap water directly, as it may contain chlorine or other chemicals that can harm your plants. These substances can interfere with the nutrient uptake and overall health of your plants. Chlorine in particular can be detrimental to plant growth. It's best to let tap water sit out for 24 hours to allow the chlorine to evaporate, or use a water conditioner to remove it. Use filtered or rainwater instead. These options are free from harmful chemicals and provide a more natural environment for your plants. Monitor the nutrient solution level regularly and top it up as needed. As the plants grow, they will consume the nutrients and water, so it's important to keep the levels consistent. Change the solution entirely every 2 to 3 weeks. This helps prevent the buildup of salts and other residues that can affect plant health. With these steps, you're well on your way to a successful hydroponic garden using the Kratky method. Happy growing! 6. Thriving gardens. Tips for passive hydroponic success. Congratulations on setting up your passive hydroponic system. Here are some tips to ensure your plants thrive. Sunlight is key. Most plants need at least 6 hours of direct sunlight per day. Choose a location accordingly or consider using grow lights. Nutrient balance. Use a high-quality hydroponic nutrient solution specifically formulated for your plant's needs. pH matters. Regularly check and adjust the pH of your nutrient solution to the optimal range for your plants. Air circulation. Good airflow is crucial to prevent mold and mildew. Ensure adequate ventilation around your system. Observe and adjust. Pay close attention to your plant's growth and adjust your system as needed. Every environment is unique. Troubleshooting time, common mistakes and solutions. Even with the best intentions, challenges can arise. It's important to recognize that these issues are part of the learning process. Here are some common mistakes and how to overcome them. Mistake 1. Inadequate lighting. Lighting is crucial for plant growth. If your plants are leggy and pale, they need more light. This is a clear sign that they are not getting enough light to thrive. Move them to a sunnier spot or use grow lights. Ensure the light source is adequate for the type of plants you are growing. Mistake 2. Nutrient deficiencies. Yellowing leaves or stunted growth can indicate a lack of nutrients. This can severely affect the health and yield of your plants. Adjust your nutrient solution or try a different brand. Sometimes experimenting with different nutrient solutions can make a big difference. Mistake 3. pH imbalance. Fluctuations in pH can hinder nutrient uptake. Maintaining a stable pH is essential for optimal nutrient absorption. Use a pH meter to monitor and adjust the solution regularly. Consistent monitoring can prevent many issues before they become serious. Mistake 4. Poor air circulation. Good airflow is vital for plant health. Lack of airflow can lead to fungal problems. Fungal issues can quickly spread and damage your entire crop. Ensure good ventilation around your system. This can be achieved with fans or by simply opening windows. Remember, patience is key. Don't get discouraged if things don't go perfectly at first. Every mistake is an opportunity to learn and improve. With a little observation and adjustment, you'll be harvesting fresh, homegrown produce in no time. The rewards of your hard work will be worth it. Cost comparison, passive versus active hydroponics. One of the most appealing aspects of passive hydroponics is its affordability. Let's compare the costs of passive and active systems. Passive systems require minimal materials and can often be built using recycled containers. They have virtually no recurring costs beyond replenishing nutrients. Active systems involve pumps, timers, and potentially grow lights, leading to higher setup costs. They incur ongoing electricity expenses. As you can see, passive hydroponics offers significant cost savings, making it an attractive option for budget-conscious growers. Inspiration grows here. Real-life success stories. Countless individuals have embraced passive hydroponics and transformed their gardening experiences. Here are a few inspiring examples. Urban Dwellers Rooftop Oasis. Sarah, living in a bustling city, created a thriving rooftop garden using the Kratky method. She now enjoys fresh salads and herbs year-round, reducing her grocery bills and carbon footprint. Off-grid homestead abundance. John and Mary, living off-grid in a remote area, rely on passive hydroponics to supplement their food supply. Their wicking system provides them with a steady supply of leafy greens and vegetables. These stories highlight the versatility and accessibility of passive hydroponics. proving that anyone can cultivate fresh food regardless of their location or resources. Take the plunge, start your hydroponic journey. Passive Hydroponics opens up a world of possibilities for growing your own food. It's affordable, sustainable, and incredibly rewarding. Whether you're a seasoned gardener or just starting, these systems offer a simple yet effective way to connect with nature and enjoy the fruits and vegetables of your labor. Start small, experiment with different systems and crops, and don't be afraid to learn from your mistakes. The journey of passive hydroponics is filled with discovery, delicious rewards, and a profound sense of accomplishment. What are you waiting for? Dive into the world of passive hydroponics and start growing your own food today. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and share your hydroponic adventures in the comments below.